The governor of South Dakota says she's still not not making masks mandatory or enforcing social distancing at you-know-who's 4th of July event at Mount Rushmore. Now, just one of the thousand celebrations that are planned nationwide for Independence Day weekend. Are too many people putting their own interests or their own false thought of what's really going on in front of everyone else's safety? I don't understand. If he says he's going to wear a mask, why she's saying she's going to, you can do it if you want to, when there are numbers. I mean, this is not, these are not fake numbers. People aren't making these up. People are actually dying. Real people are dying. People are really sick. Mm-hmm. So what do you think is going on here, Joy?
Well, they are putting their own interests above the health and welfare of their fellow Americans. That's why we have laws in this country. That's why we have drunk driving laws. That's why we require that people vaccinate their children. Hello? We have no smoking in restaurants. We have no smoking in hospitals or on airplanes. These are laws to protect not just you, but other people. You really can't depend on people to do the right thing. They have to be forced to do it. It's interesting. Americans are always screaming about their independence. We want our independence. And yet they're a complete nation of we are a complete nation of sheep. That's why advertising works so well. That's why campaign ads work so well. Mm. You know,
Well, thank you. That's all right. That happens to me all the time. There's an increasing number of reports of people lying about throwing parties that have led to new cases all over the country. I mean, what? Again, what is it that people aren't getting, Sonny? I mean, what do you think? Do you think people have to die in front of someone for somebody to recognize that this could be their future if they're not careful?
That phenomenon has been shocking to me. The phenomenon that they go to a party, someone gets the virus, or someone, you know, is test positive, and then little by little, contact tracing starts to happen because, you know, the government needs to know, public health officials need to know where the spread is happening. And people are not cooperating. They're saying, no, I wasn't at the party, never went there. And it just doesn't make sense because now you can have the virus, you can pass it on to your grandmother, you can pass it on to your parents. And that's how you stop the spread, by participating in testing and letting people know, letting public officials know that you did attend these events. There was a huge event in Rockland County where like 100 people went. And now no one knows who
they're
went because they're not being honest about having gone. And the government has had to go so far as to subpoena people. And if they don't respond, they're going to be fined like $2,000 a day. I don't understand why someone would have to go to those lengths to get people to cooperate with a public health official. It's for your own benefit. So I'm really perplexed about that particular part of this story.
And you want to keep saying to people, this is not a game. This is not a game. This is real life. I mean, and you're concerned about the domino effect of this and what it's having on businesses, right, Megan? Because if you open and then you have to reclose again, mm-hmm. who does that help?
Well, yeah, and I think to Sonny's point about contact tracing, I think we're seeing such a huge distrust in our institutions, in our leaders, obviously in the White House. But what I was saying earlier, specifically, like, Republicans are having a huge crisis of faith with our Republican leaders as well. And what's interesting to me when you're talking about businesses is we are on track to have the largest gun sales in all of American history. And it is 8.3 mm-hmm. million firearms sold in March, 145% increase since June. And when people are arming themselves, They clearly don't have faith in all establishments and all institutions. And what I'm worried about right now is when you're asking for something like contact tracing, which, yes, is in the benefit of all of our collective public health, if you don't trust your congressperson to fight for you in any instance, why would you trust that they're going to take your information and do the right thing with it? I'm not saying it's right, but I'm saying this has been so botched for months. And I think I know I have been saying on the show, and all of you know because you're my friends, that I was really hoping by the summer that we would have some clarity and then be hopeful going into fall that we could come back in studio, that our friends' businesses could reopen, et cetera, et cetera. And it does not look like that is on track to happen. So there's this huge frustration, and it just seems like we are, and again, I'm not an epidemiologist, but we do not have this under control in the way that we should. And it's very disheartening going into 4th of July weekend that we all can't do the things that we want to do.
What about you, Joy?
I want to add one more thing, sure. Whoopi, if that... I want to say one more thing. What I was talking about were conspiracy theories, that people follow conspiracy theories. Mm-hmm. I couldn't remember the word. Mm. But I don't know if this was mentioned, because I can only hear some of what you guys say sometimes. But in West Hollywood, you are now going to be fined $300 if you are walking on the street without a mask. So
where?
Money talks and everything else walks, okay? So maybe that's the way they have to start doing it. Hit people in their pocketbook. If you see people walking around without a mask, you're going to get a fine. Just like if you pass a red light. Endangering other people.
Well, you know what? I was waiting for? I've been waiting to see where all of the hot spots were, all the people who were saying, like in Southern California, no, we don't have to wear masks, it's bad for us, what in Michigan and all these places. I'd like to see where people are standing now as they start to get sick.